When you have received the report from GeneAccount, it's quite self-explaining and comprehensive, but there are some key points I want to explain to you to get the most benefit of the report. As you know, the idea is that you have the genotype tests done, and they are permanent for the whole life cycle, but there may be new drugs in the market that are relevant also in this. And that's why GeneAccount is a service that also updates the report when new drugs come to the market. But first, when we log into the GeneAccount service, you can see that there's a link, see complete report. You can click it and open the report. And now it's a PDF file. You can print the report in PDF or store it on your computer. And that is the report format you could use, for example, when visiting pharmacy or medical doctors. In the front page, you can see immediately the traffic light colors. There are red, yellow, gray, and green drug. Red means that the pharmacodynamic variation affects drug effectiveness or adverse reactions with significant clinical relevance. So that should be always checked when some of these drugs are prescribed to you. Yellow means that pharmacodynamic variation affects drug effectiveness or adverse reactions with some clinical relevance. The result should be checked before dosing the drug if the result is available. Gray is a color meaning that there are some case studies showing that there's some relevance, but it's so minor that normally the normal dose is okay. And green means that for you the normal dose is for this drug okay. On the first page is you have the list of the genes tested, and then in the graphics you see your own phenotype in red. You can also see the other options there, and short description about the gene, what it works. There are some genes that are related to drug metabolism and some in blood coagulation, for example. But this is just the background information. But then we go to the most important page. These are the recommendations. There you have all the drugs or substances in alphabetical order with the generic name, and you can immediately see the colors for these. So it's quite easy to find the red ones that are somehow problematic for you. So for example, this amitriptyline means that because the patient is ultra-rapid metabolizer in CYP2D6, the dose of amitriptyline is normally too low if normal dose is used. And then when you go through this report, there are some yellow drugs and then some red drugs. And as you see, many of the red ones are related to CYP2D6. That is the most important gene in pharmacogenomics. And then if you are very, very interested in genetics, it's also possible to see what are the variants tested in the panel. The raw data is on the large pages. Sometimes the genetist or the doctor may be interested in knowing what SNPs or what parts of the gene have been tested to make this conclusion. And that's why the information is there. But normally patients don't do anything with that data. Okay. And then when we go to the online version, we have some more features there. For example, the online search. On the front page, you can write, for example, codeine. And then you can find the instructions related to codeine. And for this case, you see this red flag and the warning that because the patient is CYP2D6, who's a rapid metabolizer, codeine shouldn't be prescribed for the patient. Or if we search for atorvastatin, then it shows green label, meaning that atorvastatin normal dose is okay for you based on this SNC01B1 gene. If you write in a drug name that has not any genetic test tested, then it doesn't give any result. So it only gives result for those drugs that are somehow relevant in our database in pharmacogenomics. And then it's also possible to use the mobile application. So you can have the same website on your mobile application, and then it's quite easy when you visit pharmacy or medical doctor. You can open the report, make the searches, or even open the PDF report and show it to your clinician or pharmacy. You can compare this pharmacogenomic report to a blood group report, but blood group is easy to print on the card. This is much more complicated, and that's why we need to have this advanced IT system where you can read all the relevant information. But as blood groups, we believe that pharmacogenomic profile will be in everyday clinical practice for each patient within the next decade. And we encourage you to find out your genomic profile to get better and more effective treatment.